Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to describe Matthew 19, the parable of marriage and divorce. We have done enough background on this parable because it's a very difficult one. And that's why Jesus said, let them hear who have ears. So, ears mean that clean ears, not waxed, that nothing goes in. So it is for those who are seeker of His word. So this parable should be understood in conjunction with John 9, the born blind person whose eyes Christ Jesus opened with spittle. So if you understand that one, and this will be not a problem to understand this one. So here Jesus say that Jesus was a preacher. Preacher means those who preach gospel. Or we call him the sower of His word. His word is sown in the hearts of the people. The spiritual principle, His word is spiritual principles of God. And He, Christ Jesus, was the first anointed Christ, royal high priest of God, called a Satguru in Punjabi. In Indian language, we call him a Satguru, to appear in the present dark age. This age is called dark because the spirit from the rabbis had been taken away because they started loving mammon. So those who love mammon, they can only then ply dead letters. So that's why they were not living as explained earlier. And I have made a tree which I will also explain. Tree of life. Christ Jesus was not a teacher of the moral laws of Moses that are formulated by men inspired by His word. Thus Moses put on Christ and rejected the riches of Pharaohs and wrote Torah for the chosen people and the Gentile. So people like John the Baptist, you know, he also rejected riches and he went to the wilderness, putting on a camel skin and living on honey and locust. Moral teacher is called a rabbi in Middle East and a pandit or a guru, simply a guru, in the East. For the roots of sound moral laws being in His word, the rabbi or pandas are also said to be the witness to the light. The witness means they are act like moon. Moon, as you know, the light from the moon is reflected and comes on the earth. So moon is a witness that there is a sun over there too, whose light he is receiving and reflecting. Same, you know, the rabbis, which were, they were ideal, they used to get the light of Christ, which is oral Torah, and then they used to formulate the moral laws or go by the moral laws. And those moral laws being living, they were flexible, not rigid like the present one. So the to the light of the sun, but not the lights. So those are, they themselves are not light. Light is Christ. This is the age of Christ. So in this one, the Christ, which is inner man, is to go by, and you have to make His word as your teacher or guru. This is written in our Punjabi, Pavan Aramb. Pavan means the word of God. Ram means start, beginning. Pavana Ram Satguru Matvela, and it is the age that when you should go by your Christ, which is the inner man. Because everyone has to give his own account to God, nobody else. Satguru Mat Mera, Pavana Ram Satguru Mat Mela, Shabd Guru, Shabd his word is the teacher, Shabd Guru Surt Tun Chela. Surt means that the one who is a man of spirit. You know, in English it is called spirit, in Punjabi we call it a Surti. Surti and spirit, the same thing. So the person who has a spirit, he is the chela, mean disciple of God, or we call him a worker. An ideal moral teacher has been defined by Jesus in Matthew 13:52. Therefore, every moral teacher which is instructed unto the kingdom of heaven. Remember that moral teachers, they lead you to the kingdom of heaven that is seen in law and order in the world. So, royal priest lead you to the kingdom of God. Unto the kingdom of heaven is like unto a man, not a woman. A rabbi cannot be a woman. That is an householder, that is hereditary priest of a temple, as the people of Levi tribe are of synagogues in the Middle East, which bringeth forth out of his treasures of gnosis or knowledge, things new. New is his word, or the oral Torah, the middle candle of the menorah. That was preached from the oral Torah, his word, but was received only through the grace of God. Nobody can have his word without the grace of God. And the grace of God you get when you are not greedy, when you are not worshipping mammon. As these present clerics, they are paid in money, and where can they get the his word then? They are greedy people. I call them wolves in sheep's clothing. And these antichrists were not happy when I went to Cluj in Romania in one of the ecumenical meeting. So they were sore annoyed with me. So they told the British lady who was the president of that ecumenical forum, that we don't like him, he is very taunting us, he is upsetting us. So all those then get together to tell me, that lady told me, don't come next time to Lyon. I said, okay, no problem. And as explained earlier, that she asked me if I'm a Christian. I said, no, I'm not a Christian, I preach Christianity, I believe in Jesus, but not a Christian. What could I be? She couldn't understand that. Unless you have Christ in your heart, you cannot preach gospel. So when she insisted, you know, then I said, okay, I'm a Christ with small c. So that made of me a laughing stock to the others when she told, oh, he say he's a Christ, something is wrong with his head. So this is how Jesus was not telling his workers not to tell anybody that he is the Christ. So Christ is not something which is ordinary, it is extraordinary treasures. So it is not to be easily taken, it should be treated with grace and honor. So he is like a his word that was preached from the oral, but was received only through grace of God, and the knowledge of which also enabled the moral teacher to overrule the written Torah. Remember, they were written Torah, thus the seat of his word could also be mercy and the old letters. Thank you.